Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Little Curves. And today is Monday, so yesterday was Friendship Day. So I just want to wish you all a happy Friendship Day. And you have seen in my Insta story how I celebrated. I celebrated with my in-laws, like my mom and dad, and it was very good. You know, your family can also become your friends. It's not like you just need friends all the time. I have realized now that even family can become your friends. And now I will not waste more of time and get back to the video. So let's get started. So today's video is a very important topic. Like this is one of the most important thing which we all should know, that we should always buy a foundation or a base very, very smartly. That's really very important. And I get most of your questions like, di ye color acha lag raha hai ya ye color acha lagega, mera rang aisa hai to main kaun sa color, you know, people are confused. So I thought of making this and helping you out. So the first tip is, whenever you go to buy a foundation, just go clean slate. Do not apply any foundation onto yourself so that you can do a patch test. Now the second tip is to do your patch test, that is onto your jawline, and later you have to do over here also on your forehead. Please don't do it on your wrist only. That doesn't help so much, because this area is more fair as compared to your skin other areas, because you know this is not so exposed. Like this arm, like this place and even this place have a difference. So it's better to go on your jawline, like your half neck and half up on your face or your cheek, and later to again recheck it onto your forehead. That's really very important. Now comes the third thing, is that most of us are into the feeling that, you know, you should buy any foundation which makes you feel fair. It's not that way. Just look into your color. If your color is dark and you go to a lighter shades, it will look very cakey, very fake onto your skin. So you please understand that you take colors which is according to your shade. And if you have to mix two colors together, if you're not getting the perfect shade, go for it. Mix two colors together and then apply. That's perfectly fine. Now comes the fourth thing which we should always understand before buying, is to understand your skin type. Your skin type changes according to the to the season also. So it's better, like my skin is normal to dry, so I use any liquid foundation, but during winters when it tends to get dry, I use a creamy foundation. Okay, so please understand your skin type. It varies according to season. Now most of the time it do happens like your T-zone is oily and this area, like your cheek area, is not at all. So you have to mix two foundations. Like for this area you have to apply something else, and for this area something else. Okay, so combination skin have to work a bit. Now comes the other tip, which is for sensitive skin. Now sensitive skin, it becomes really very tough to get a good foundation for them. So you start using any liquid foundation rather than any creamy foundation, just because creamy foundation has oil in it and that will tend to make pimples onto your skin. Your skin already is sensitive. So use something which is light to your skin. Use something which is liquid in consistency, just because it will let your skin to calm down. It will not give that urge of, you know, any rashes or any pimples or anything else. So don't apply any oil based one, apply liquid based one. Now the other thing to understand your skin tone is your veins. Your veins really help. Just look at your veins, whether they have blue lines or green lines, like your veins are blue or green tone. If they are into green tones, then you are a warm shade. You know, you are someone who should take yellow tones of, you know, colors like pigments, okay, or foundations. And if you are into the purple one or the blue one, you are into cool zone and your color will be more of the pinkish kind of, okay? So you have to apply any light tones, okay? So it depends. Now if I check my veins are neutral. So most of the times it becomes really very easy when you have a neutral tone to pick up colors and you get the color which you want, okay? But if you have you know, you just have to check where you are into pink zone or yellow zone. So that is really very, very important to understand it. Now comes, there is one more thing which you should always keep it in mind, is according to the occasion you're wearing your foundation and the coverage you want. So it depends, like every day, if you want a normal skin for every day, I would suggest you to go for a BB cream or CC cream. But in case if you want like a party makeup kind of, you have to invest little bit more to give a heavy coverage, to give a full coverage to your skin. And for medium casual, like, you know, like Sunday look or something, you have to go for something which is affordable, like, you know, Maybelline, L'Oreal, these are affordable brands and they give you a good kind of coverage also. But in case if you want full coverage or you have a quite of acne or something, blemishes and all, and you have to cover them fully, it's better to go for MAC, Bobbi Brown, or, you know, Huda Beauty, such kind of products. And don't use it in everyday basis, just use it on your party wear in case if you want to go out somewhere. So that time only these will give you maximum coverage, as well as it will help your makeup to stay on place. Okay, so it depends according to your skin type plus the kind of coverage you want, you know, it totally depends on that. And even it's not just the foundation works accord with it, like with your foundation also, for the dark circles, your, you know, color corrector works. And to just minimize those oiliness, even your pressed powder works. Things work hand in hand. Your primer also works with your foundation. So some things work hand in hand with these all things, and they make together your skin look very flawless. So understand this, like you have your lines. Now these lines, smile lines, even it happened crazy. Most of the time it happens to me also. Now what do I do for that? I use my color corrector or a base kind of thing, which I apply on this area to fill this area, so that later when I apply my foundation, it stays on place. Okay, now I don't have a oily skin, so I don't use powder, press powders more. But if you have a oily skin, you have to use it. Okay, so these are small things which you should keep it in mind while shopping your foundation. And please, I would request you not to go online. Like every time I get messages that I'm going to buy this online, will this shade match? Most of the time it doesn't. If you're buying the another bottle of the same shade, then it's okay. But if you're doing for the first time, go to any shop, just try it, ask them, they are there to help you. And most of the time go on in the daylight, you know, daylight will be very good to check the coverage, to check the perfect shade, because in those yellow spotlight you are not able to understand your skin tone much clearly. So better to go during daylight time and just pick up the perfect color for yourself. Base is really very important, so don't play with it, don't just blindly go and experiment with things. It's better to just understand, like, people are fair, but they have, you know, the yellow tone or the pink tone. Now I sometimes have pink tone, this cheek area becomes red, I don't have yellow tone. So, you know, mistakes happen from me also. So it's better to understand, and these are some of the tips which I really take into consideration when I pick up my pigments. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video too. Do subscribe to my channel, hit the button like, and stay tuned for more and more videos. Thank you so much for watching, and happy Friendship Day again. Bye.